Hi folks, welcome back to the Horde. About 7:15, the September 7th, Sunday. What is that, 73.5 degrees, 72 on this one. Batteries obviously are in charge, the sun's down. And 23.5, it's actually comfortable at the moment. Humidity's down. I think I've told you guys, my son buying a house out in York or Adams counties of Pennsylvania, and I was out there this weekend helping him pick it out and look it over and so forth. And while I was out there, we went to a place known as Morning Star, Morning Shine, Morning something. It's a flea market. It's at the border of Adams and York counties. Thompsonville, something like that, I think. Anyway, so I was out there, had to get some toys. A couple of the toys I got, I've told you guys, I like interesting lamps, light bulbs. You guys got to check this out. Well, the way this works is this thing right here is a magnet. So when you put electricity through the filament, you get a positive, negative, or reversing pole magnet from the AC going through the filament, which makes it flicker back and forth at 60 cycles because of the magnet there. So I thought that was cool. Something to add to the light bulb collection. Well, I was there also. There were a couple of guys, Daryl and his brother Daryl, and they had these clutches. Max Torque. I think you guys could see that. Pair of them. The way you remove a clutch, torch, not the best thing. It appears as if he did have some trouble with the Allen keys. What I'll do is I'll drill them out and resize them. Looks like that one wouldn't come out. I don't know. So this one, he heated up. It looks like he might have done a little damage to the bronze bushing there. This one, he didn't get to the bronze bushing side. He did the other side. So looks like there's plenty of meat left on those clutches. Gave him $10 for both clutches. The light bulb, actually I got another light bulb also, but it's just a very bright one. That was also 50 cents, so these were 50 cents each, so a big dollar. So I spent $11. What they also have around that area of Pennsylvania, they have a lot of Amish folk, and they make something called Whoopee Pies. This is a Whoopee Pie. I love Whoopee Pies. And I try to buy them wherever I go because I really like them. They also have Whoopee Pies in Mystic, Connecticut, that whoever makes them in Mystic, there's a little bakery there right along the Connecticut River. If you're familiar, well, anyway, it's on the, it's right near the Marine Salvage place. How do I know? Because I go to the Marine Salvage place too. Anyway, the they make a really nice Whoopee Pie, but their Whoopee Pie is like 10 times bigger than this. It's huge. Their Whoopee Pie is like that big, right? Excellent, excellent Whoopee Pie. So anyway, Pennsylvania Dutch folks made up that Whoopee Pie for me. They were selling, I think it was 8 for 6 1/4, but those are excellent. Really enjoy them. Yeah, I didn't buy much. We got there late. We didn't get there until, I don't know, 1, 2 o'clock, something like that. So, all the bargains were already gone. We drove out from here, left in the morning at 6. It's about a 4-hour ride. 5-hour ride, 6, well, we didn't get out the door until close to 7. Didn't get there to 11. Then we were at his house for a little while. Then we went over to the market, so we didn't get to the market. Probably about 12:31. So that was a good time. Anyway, he put a bid in on a house. We'll see if that all comes through. And I was also working on a deal for another 200S. This one was a barn find. It was in beautiful, beautiful condition. But unfortunately, I was on my way home when the deal closed on eBay. So I just put a bid out there. And, you know, the bid hit. And then whoever jumped over my bid at the last minute. Normally what I like to do if I want something, my bid was high enough to get it, but because I wasn't there, you know, somebody went like a dollar over my bid and ended up with the three-wheeler. What I like to do is if I want something and it's worth $500 to me, it's not really wise to bid $500 the first day for something, because it can work its way up to $500 and beyond. It's better to hang back. And if it's like $300 in the last 5 minutes, and then, you know, like the last 30 seconds, you put in that $500 bid, chances are you'll get it for less than your $500. Where if they see your $500 bid a few days before, or even 15 minutes before, you'll have somebody willing to pay $501, and then you lose it, right? You might also be willing to pay $501, but if you put in $501, they'll go $502. So, you know, you really have to be there at the end of the auction. And unfortunately, I wasn't, so the bike got by. Cosmetically, it was an absolutely perfect bike, beautiful. Tires were dry rotted, so it would have needed some tires, but cosmetically, it was a beautiful, beautiful bike. The guy did not get it running, though all the mechanicals hanging off the engine look good, the exhaust look good, just the recoil look good, even had the compression release on it. It was beautiful. So even if it had a blown engine, which I didn't think so. It didn't look like it was mistreated. And even if I had to pop for three tires, and obviously I got plenty of tires in the Horde, so that wouldn't have been an issue. So even if I had to put one of my Horde engines on it, it was worth, you know, $400 to me because of how pretty it was. Nice looking bike. Unfortunately, it went for just over my $400 maximum, but It was low all day. As a matter of fact, this morning it was only $136. So if I could have been bidding at the end of the auction the last 30 seconds, probably if I would have dropped that $400 bid on it while it was still, you know, $150, $175, $200, you know, I probably would have got it for less than my $400 bid. It probably would have been $350. All right, I'm going to run. I have another video to do, and I'll probably do it tomorrow on some parts that showed up. And I was at my son's, we ran around the winery and played with some of his toys there. So I got some pictures of that I'll show you guys. But we'll save that for tomorrow. Anyway, folks, thanks for watching. Thanks for commenting. Thanks for subscribing. We'll catch you on the next episode of The Horde. Till then, remember to keep your feet down, your head up, and enjoy your lives. Bye now.